Hi, I'm Vanessa, and I love bad Star Trek. I break down the bad episodes of my favorite show so you don't have to watch it. I will be the pipe cleaner covered crab legs that is Star Trek's original series. Today, I will be talking to you about an episode called Catspaw. Since it's almost Halloween, I thought it would make a lot of sense to talk about a Halloween themed episode of Star Trek in all of its very on the nose, spoopy creepiness. With its fog and skeleton and witches and black castle and a black cat and a wizard, scary wizard. But there's not much of a plot, I'm afraid. It's a very run-of-the-mill pre-Scooby-Doo type episode, except when they pull the mask off, it's not some cranky old man saying like, I would have gotten away with it if it weren't for you dirty motherfuckers. It's more like little aliens dinging from very visible strings. It's entertaining, sort of, because it's a 45-minute Scooby-Doo episode. So it begins with the Enterprise orbiting a planet called Pyrus 7, where Captain Kirk is starting to get real pissed because his away team hasn't contacted him, and it consists of his pilot Sulu, his chief engineer Scotty, and crewman Jackson. And when Uhura, the communications officer, after many urgent hails, finally makes contact, she gets a very chilling response. One to beam up. Just crewman Jackson. No Sulu. No Scotty. And Jackson is beamed up by this transporter engineer, Kyle. And I just want to stop here for a second and touch on this Kyle guy. I had no idea who he was, but Memory Alpha has a huge article about him. He's been through a lot of shit, just like Miles O'Brien. Give it up for Kyle. Golf clap for Kyle. Anyway, Kyle beams up crewman Jackson, who stands there awkwardly for about 10 seconds, not saying anything, and then Jackson takes a tumble in one of the most concerning pratfalls I think I've seen on the original series. The actor was a stunt guy, but it really looked like he fell flat on his face. But buckle up, everyone. Here comes the spoopy stuff. As crewman Jackson's mouth is open like a freshly caught fish, a disembodied voice seems to be coming out with a foreboding warning.
There is a curse on your ship. Leave this place, or you will all die.
And Kirk looks sad, but also exasperated, like, ugh, this is happening. This is something I have to deal with now. God damn it. But Kirk has to go down to the planet's surface anyway because he has to rescue Scotty and Sulu, and he brings his buddies, both Bones and Spock. And they look around very confused because the planet is covered in fog. This absolutely should not be here. There's no bodies of water. There's no moisture in the air. It's pretty dry. Really dry.
Y'all, it's very dry. It's almost kind of like your vagina.
Speaking of vagina, that's when the moaning starts. If you've ever lived in an apartment with shared walls, you know what I'm talking about.
Now, what do you think that
went?
What I want to know is who hears moaning and goes, let's go investigate. So they really just ask for what comes next. Yeah, that's pretty typical for Chicago as well. Yeah, lady, I'm gonna die tonight, just like I was gonna die last night and the night before, so I'm just gonna go home now. Peace, you know. I just love how operatic they are. And by the way, they were supposed to be, like, floating heads, but the light on them was too bright and you can very clearly see the turtlenecks that they're wearing. So they look like beatniks that don't exfoliate. And I love Spock's literary criticisms here.
Spock. Comment.
Very bad poetry, Captain.
A more useful comment, Mr. Spock.
And their skin is about as rocky as the big black castle that they find that has a black cat in it. Wow, no cliches here. Finally, Bones is like, yeah, We got fog and witches and a castle and a cat. Someone's doing a trick or treat on us. And there's this weird beat where Spock goes, "What's that?" And Kirk's like, "Nope, not telling you." Why? Why not tell him what Halloween is? Kirk, it takes like 2 seconds. People dress up, get drunk, and eat candy. Like, that's how many words was that? Was that really that hard? And this comes up again later on, and they just refuse to tell him. And I just hope that he gets a lesson and a whole history lesson on Samhain, and Bones dresses up as Spock to teach him. Back on the Enterprise, we have Chekhov that seems to have inherited the Three Stooges wig collection, and he is worried about yet another landing party losing contact with the Enterprise. And back at the castle, the fearsome threesome fall through some floor. Why would they follow a black cat into a castle thinking that the castle was up to code? Really? Well, that's a bad decision making here, you know? There's likely some kid in there setting up booby traps. All three end up in wrist chains next to a skeleton. Woo! And when they wake up in the wrist restraints and Kirk goes through the spoopy list again, Kirk says, "This is Earth stuff. Why do they have Earth stuff? This shouldn't be here. Why is it?" It does resemble something of an off boardwalk haunted house at Myrtle Beach, between the edgy t-shirts and macho margaritas. And Spock thinks that whoever created this shithole understood man's deepest fears. Really? Some guy with dry skin, bad hair, and wearing a turtleneck singing a song is scary? I don't think so. Kirk thinks that he's saved when he sees Scotty and Sulu. But oh no, they've been brainwashed. And Memory Alpha says that Scotty and Sulu say almost nothing for this episode.
"Scotty, do you hear me? Sulu, do you know who I am? What's happened to you?"
They get lets them loose from their restraints, and they meet the resplendent lead guitarist from Anthrax, Korob the Wizard. And the cat is talking to him or something.
"Why all the mumbo jumbo?
Mumbo jumbo?
Oh.
Oh no, I assure you it was not that, Captain."
And Spock lets Kirk know about what familiars are.
"Familiars? Demons in animal form sent by Satan to serve the wizard. Superstition.
I do not create the legend, Captain. I merely report it."
Why does he know what a familiar is, but he doesn't know what Halloween is? Not saying witchcraft is the same, whatever. Spock is just the best part of this anyway. Korob's like a Bond villain, because instead of just killing them or torturing them some more, he's like, "Give me your Tempur-Pedic number so you can sleep on the most comfortable mattress. What is your favorite food?" The pig head, though, not so appetizing. So Bones says, "We're not hungry," but the bald guy says, "Eat the food.
Eat the food.
Here's some jewelry. Stop asking questions." And Kirk says, "We can definitely replicate all of this, so it's kind of worthless." It's a very irritating issue in a video game when you think you have the thingy for the quest and it's the wrong thingy. And that's the look Korob has on his face. So he's sweating. And from here on, he just sounds like he's just making shit up as he goes along. He's like, "Well, that's not what I read. What did you read, Korob? Wuthering Heights? Castles? Come on, man. That's not scary at all." So he goes, "Okay, you've passed the test. Yeah, you came down here even with a weird voice and the witches. So you're like loyal to your crew, and you've denied yourself riches, and you were tested in bravery, and you weren't scared, and you can't be bribed. So you win." And the cat takes off to change into a woman, of course, and her hair is way higher than Ardra's. So that's pretty impressive. So she's like a sexy gothic Q-tip, and she holds a tiny replica of the Enterprise over a candle, and finally Kirk can make contact with the Enterprise, only for Chekhov to go, "Oh man, it's hot in here. Take off those velveteen sweaters, maybe. They're like animal pelts. Of course it's hot." The rest of the episode is Kirk trying to get some answers, Korob and Sylvia the cat lady stubbornly refusing to give them. And Korob and Sylvie are like, tell us what we want to know. What is it you want to know? They never ask anything specific. Like, do you know science? Like, yes. That's kind of a big topic, you know? Like, what? And Kirk doesn't want to help them, so he's like, we're going to be unhelpful. And he doesn't say anything. So Korob goes, fine. And he puts the Enterprise necklace into some plastic thing, and kind of like Jim put Dwight's office supplies in Jell-O. Like, I can see it, but I can't get it. The Enterprise, meanwhile, thinks they're in a force field, which prompts the standing captain to babble on about Navy beans for some reason.
Engineering, stand by to divert all power systems to the outer hull. Prepare impulse engines for generation of maximum heat directed as ordered. Maybe we can't break it. But I'll bet you credits to Navy beans we can put a dent in it.
You know who wouldn't try to just bust through a force field? Uhura! She should be captain, just saying. Spock and Kirk are chained up a second time. I don't know why. And Bones, meanwhile, is brainwashed and Sulu goes to unlock them again. See, this is getting, like, a little repetitive. They're just going back and forth from one room to the other. And then Sylvia goes, wee! Because it's, like, a sensation that's new to her. Like torturing and scaring people, even Korob, which causes an argument, so there's trouble in paradise.
We have a duty to the old ones.
What do they know of sensations? This is a new world.
Cruel. You torture our specimens.
And that too is a new sensation. I find it stimulating.
And he thinks she's getting a little greedy, but we definitely did not need to see this close-up shot of him. That's too many. That's too many. I don't need to see his pores. Thank you. We also didn't need to see Kirk trying to seduce Sylvia, even if it does result in some interesting magic where she changes clothes and wigs several times, one even higher than the one she has. And I'm not sure what's sexy about hair that looks like you cut it yourself in a bad way in a huge clowny pantsuit. But whatever, people into clowns, fine. Kirk does this to get answers about her powers coming from a transmuter, which she picks up on and reacts as though she was rebound from OkCupid.
You hold me in your arms and there is no fire in your mind. You're trying to deceive me. It's here, like words on a page. You are using me!
And Korob conspires to get them said transmuter and pays for that with his life when a door falls on him. Kirk smashes it and then Sulu, Scotty, and Bones are free from being controlled and it's over. But almost. Not quite over. Because as it turns out, the sexy lady and the bald guy are actually little aliens which were made of pipe cleaners, crab legs, and blue fluff. And the crab legs as a Marylander made me want to chew through the screen. And they were dangling from these strings which were apparently very visible except on the remastered version which is on most streaming services. So you actually can't see it. I just wish that this had a better plot because it was kind of fun. I loved Spock in it. Even Kirk using his masculine wiles to get answers from somebody was kind of funny, as was Sylvia's ecstatic changing into ugly clothes and ugly wigs. But the plot, super boring. Very boring. And they could have done a lot better. Even if this was bad on purpose. Like, subscribe. No pressure, but peer pressure. Till next time. I guess.